Hi, this is Camelot, and this is a new software created by Audio Modeling, the creators of Swam Engine Virtual Instruments plugin, and Fatar. This new software has been created to manage the live performance, keeping in mind the needs of the keyboard player. And also our aim is to let the player connect hardware and software instruments together in one place. So this is the main interface of Camelot that has the first view, that is the set list view, where you can arrange your concert in a list of songs. Inside the song you can create as many scenes that you need to perform. In this example we have created an intro, verse, chorus, an ending scene, but you can add any scene and create and arrange your patch changes as you like. When you switch to the scene and you see the scene detail, this is an empty scene, but let me switch to one that has some example. You can collect all the sounds and that you need to perform, and inside each layer that you can see you can attach hardware or software instruments. The cool thing that we have done is that we are working with hardware manufacturers to create maps of their instruments, so the user does not have to learn the MIDI implementation map to select a sound. I select the MIDI port for the instruments, and then I access directly the sound from the instrument. I can refresh and get my user patches from the instruments, so basically I don't have to learn MIDI.
So from the start on, how many developers will be on board?
Basically we are a team of four, but we are also working in partnership with the hardware companies to get help and support from them.
Basically. So this will grow in the next time, in the next month or in next year?
And also in terms of hardware instruments, here you can select plugins. We have VST audio unit plugins, so you can search for example and add an alto sax from Swam Audio Modeling. You load it automatically and then you access directly the interface of the plugin. You set everything you need to play, and the state of the plugin will be saved in this scene. When you need to switch to the next scene, you go and automatically go there to play. You can, for each layer, you can manage the input settings, so the input controllers, and also you are able to play MPE with MPE controllers. So if I connect a Rolly Seaboard or an instrument to Camelot, I'm able to directly plug and play also other instruments that are multi-part.
How easy is it now for us, not a keyboard from Studio Logic or from a different company? Are there mappings already available, or do you plan to manage this different way with MIDI CC or?
We are also working to map input controllers. There will be a MIDI section for mapping that is not ready yet, but here in the MIDI settings there will be a MIDI mapping. So there will be a bunch of controllers that are mapped, but an easy MIDI learn to directly map your own controller if not listed there. Also, we have a cool feature that is the attachment feature, So you can attach to any scene a PDF or image. So when you perform, you will be able to view your annotation, your music score directly straight to that point for that scene. It's very easy to attach a PDF to a scene. I'll show you. When the PDF is not attached, you can see all the items that are in the database. You can select the PDF, you can adjust the zoom and the position for that scene, and then you press apply. That's it.
So it's mainly PDF or
PDF, PNG, JPEG images.
Do you support also from bigger brands this patch editor, or this way can Node annotation software, or is it only for PDF or
now,
simple documents?
In the first early release, we will have only support for attachments, but we are looking for partnership also from companies that are making other contents, editor, and also to sell music score or any contents that can match the needs of the keyboard player. Also, in our roadmap, we would like to add other layers. Now you have seen the instrument layers to manage hardware and software, but also we are adding audio layers to manage backing tracks, loops, DAW layer integration, direct integration with those. So I want to load my Ableton project to run in parallel with my keyboard rig. That's it. And also light show, the MIDI allow us to connect many different devices, digital mixers, so you can manage all the different items that you need during a show, video, playback during the show.
So you can map also to your plugins, not only instruments but also effects and all this stuff.
Yeah, of course.
How intensive is the application? Is it CPU-wise good or?
Well, everything depends on the plugin that you have loaded and.
So the basic configuration, if you put nothing in inside, is it already heavy or is it no?
It's pretty light. We are working very hard to optimize the plugin pools to make it very efficient. Actually, what we are doing is to load all the plugins inside a song and then empty the pool. For example, if I'm switching song, you see, then I'm loading 10 plugins, and I have a progress bar that gives me the indication about the plugin that are remaining to be loaded. But we are working to make this more and more efficient.
And already back on NAMM show, I talked with John Rides.
Yeah.
He told me he's involved in this project.
Yeah. This software was born starting a chat with him. We worked previously on different projects on GeoShred, so has been we had a collaboration for a long time. So Jordan is in the loop and is contribute a lot to improve
and
this product.
There is also a iOS version.
Yes, an important thing that is not only for Mac. It runs on Windows and also on iOS. And at the NAMM show and here we have also a version for iPad.
And how do you will you sell it, or do you bundle it with your keyboards, or how do you will?
Well, this is Basically, we are working on that. We are planning to sell Camelot soon, but also we are trying to arrange a partnership with hardware manufacturers to make bundles.
Okay.
So there will be different, hopefully different options for the user to access Camelot in different ways.
And when we can expect it, or this year, or?
Yeah, it will be this year. We are going to start very soon a beta testing program with a public beta. And of course, anyone interested to join can go to camelotpro.com website and register for the beta that will be sent in May. And after this heavy test, hopefully we'll be ready to launch in summer or autumn.
And it looks like a bit like the next main stage or the from a concurrent for Apple main stage. Is there many differences between this software and now? Is it better or easier to use?
What well, we tried to make the life easier for the user, also starting from the hardware user in mind.
So and especially for Windows users.
And Windows users, yeah. There is no main stage for mobile and iOS. So basically, we're trying to expand a bit the scope of that, also for the light show management and all the modules that will come later, basically.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much.